now above ground and determined to push towards the coast by following the sun due west, Joe and Matt will have to move away from the saltwater-filled cenote to find a reliable source of hydration. Groundwater in the Yucatan is always scarce, and from November through May, the dry season depletes the moisture in even the hardiest of succulent plants.
Hey, Joe, check this out.
What is that?
This is the chom fruit that the locals eat around here.
Known throughout the Yucatan as chom or chom chom, this variety of wild pineapple will supply Joe and Matt with a small but essential amount of water and electrolytes to replenish their energy.
Bite the skin open, split it. Now, whole inside, all that seedy flesh in there. You can eat all the seeds. You want to be careful of the hairs.
Oh, man.
You take a bite of it, and immediately it moistens your mouth. Plus, it's gonna give us some sugars and carbohydrates, a little bit of energy.
Isn't that good?
Yeah, I needed that.
Finding this chom fruit is a huge mental boost, and I've said it a million times. Help yourself whenever you can and how you can.
How many more do we have in here? Let's grab all of these.
Let's leave two. I wanna make sure that the plant has a chance to reseed itself.
You're always thinking about nature, I see.
Well, we take care of it, takes care of you.
I just met Matt. We haven't worked together for very long, but this guy is in tune with nature in a very unique way.
It looks like there's a few more up in here, which is great, because I kind of feel bad that we took so many, but I think there'll be enough fruits for the area.
Yeah, if we find more, let's just grab them as we go.
Leaving fruit behind because he wants to reseed that plant is a little off kilter for me.
I'll take point. I'll keep going. Okay. How much farther do you want to move today? We've come a long ways, brother, and it's getting late.
We still got time for maybe another hour walk.
Bro, I don't want to be making a shelter in the dark.
I can go both ways. I agree, I don't want to make a shelter at night, but I'm also concerned we haven't found water.
Dude, it's your call.
Well, I'll tell you what, there are some spots around here, and it seems like there's a bunch of different materials. Why don't we plan on making a shelter here?
That works for me, but I can tell you this, I'm not sleeping on the ground. I'm getting eaten alive. I've got bites all over me.
Yeah, you're getting it already.
All right, well, let's get to work, man. I want to stand around admiring my legs.
You got it. I've been building primitive shelters for over 20 years. It's a matter of looking at the terrain and saying, all right, what's going to fit here?
With only small trees to work with, Matt utilizes standing trunks. The root system will stabilize each post, ensuring that the frame will support the weight of two adult males.
It's really solid here. It's quick. It makes sense for this terrain that's out here. I'm gonna make a glue. It's gonna be a protective border out of the sapote tree, which has latex. Just gotta find one. Oh. Whoa, that's a tropical rattlesnake. This thing is enormous, it's gorgeous. It's a dangerous animal.
A bite from a tropical rattlesnake delivers neurotoxins that can lead to shock, paralysis, permanent blindness, and even respiratory failure.
I want to respect this beautiful creature. It belongs here. I'm a newbie in this forest. It's his home. So I'm just going to go ahead and slowly back away right now.
I'm used to seeing rattlesnakes at home. The key right now is just to keep eye contact and slowly backstep, being careful not to kick anything. And gracefully walk away from it.
Yeah, look at this thing.
What do you have there, brother?
I've got some sap from the latex tree out there. I'm just gonna paint this around for bug protection.
Oh, great idea.
This looks great. Good job.
Dude, I made you a pillow.
I love it. That's awesome.
It's a solid platform. We're off the ground. We're going to be good for tonight.
You need a hand with that?
Relax. I'll take you up on that, man. So I'll just put a thin bead around here just to keep the bugs from crawling up.
Does it have a smell to it? Is that what keeps it away? I mean, what exactly is that stuff?
Basically, it's just a sticky barrier. They can't walk
through
it.
That's smart.
Matt really knows his stuff. That's a great gold nugget that's going in my tactical toolbox.
You won't believe what I saw just over here. There was a tropical rattlesnake. It was about 4 feet long, about that big around, the most beautiful orangish patterns.
Did you think about killing it?
It was way too beautiful. If you saw it, you would have known what I'm talking about. It was gorgeous.
Food source, bro.
That is a target of opportunity. Not to kill it because it's beautiful, I don't get that. That doesn't register with me at all.
Let me just make sure I understand this. The reason you didn't kill it, it wasn't the fact that it was a dangerous snake. It was just, it was beautiful.
Yeah, it was beautiful.
I don't like someone making a decision like that on my behalf.
You know, I'm starving right now. We could have whipped up a quick fire and at least nibbled on it.
Looking at that snake, it's so gorgeous. And I just felt like, you know, this is our first night here in this jungle. I just felt like it would be a respectful, honorable thing just to let it be.
I ran across a rattlesnake once in New Mexico. You know what I did? I killed it and cut its head off, and we ate it.
You should have killed the damn thing. That's food.
It is food, but...
But dude, you made a decision on my behalf, too, not to take...
Just that particular one, I just couldn't do it inside. When I enter a new area, day one, for me, is a time to really observe it, get to know it. I felt like this was a blessing that was brought upon me, and I just wanted to watch it, see if it had anything to teach and respect its territory.
Do me a favor, the next time something like that happens, would you call me? Because remember, we're out here together and, you know, I'm starving right now.
I think there'll be opportunities for us to still get some meat.
I wonder if there's not.
I don't think one snake's gonna be the difference between us surviving or not.
I hope you're right.
Joe has different philosophy than I do. Rightfully so, he came from a background as a warrior. My background is out here with nature. I don't want to just come here and crush everything and take from it.
And I'm quite frankly a little he didn't kill that snake. That was food that just got away. And we may not get that opportunity again.
Oh, yeah.
Stay on your side of the bed. Yeah, man, I don't know about you, but rattlesnake sounds pretty damn good about right now.
Yeah. But you know what happens? If we kill that one rattlesnake, they'll come back after us. The rattlesnakes will come back with vengeance.
With a new day in Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula, Joe and Matt continue navigating west, walking away from the rising sun toward the coast, while their immediate focus is on finding key resources like water and food to fuel their journey.
Right now, we are heading to a coastline, any coastline, but on the way, we have got to find a water source to replenish the water we've lost. I'm looking and I don't see anything. I don't know what he's looking at, but he is sure he has seen something.
Stay right here. Stay outside.
I've got one shot at this. These turkey are incredibly fast. Just one slip up, that turkey's running through the forest and taking flight.
What's going on in there? Talk to me.
I cut its head off, try to be quick and clean. As soon as I killed the turkey, I said a little prayer for it silently.
Oh, nice.
Very, very nice.
This will be a nice meal for us.
I was kind of Matt for not killing a snake, but all sins are forgiven. This is a huge score for us.
Dude, that was badass. Well done. Well done.